It's week five of the ICANN Challenge. Five local people with heart disease and diabetes, along with our very own Evan Forrester, are on a 12-week course to better health. So far, the challengers have worked on health habits like watching what they eat, portion control, and increasing their physical activity. Tonight, it's making sure to keep close tabs on alcohol and tobacco. Here's Evan with tonight's ICANN Challenge.
Drinking in large amounts can have a negative effect on health, and by now we all know the dangers that come from smoking. In the U.S., smoking is the leading preventable cause of death. More than 440,000 Americans die from tobacco-related causes every single year.
Smoking is the leading cause of lung cancer. It also causes mouth, throat, bladder, pancreatic, and kidney cancers. Cigarettes are packed with dangerous chemicals and tar.
That would be the equivalent of a year's worth of tar building up inside of the lungs, smoking a pack a day for 1 year.
Right now it's a challenge, but it's a way of life.
Felix Gonzalez used to smoke a pack and a half a day. He quit when he developed his heart condition and diabetes.
I tried the gum, I tried the patches, I tried everything. That scare of knowing that my health was in jeopardy helped me to stop.
What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Oh my God, I'm killing myself.
Vicki Kelly quit her pack and a half a day habit years ago because of her children. She used pretzel sticks instead of cigarettes to keep her hands busy.
So I would drag on my pretzel, and after a while, I would just eat my pretzel and go on about it, and I didn't go back to the smoking.
Quitting is not easy, especially those first few days.
Within that first 72 hours, you have that peak withdrawal from the nicotine. That's when that peak physiological withdrawal happens, at 72 hours. So 3 days in, it's going to be a doozy.
When preparing to quit, pick a date and stick to it. Find a family member or a friend to join you. Divert the smoking urge with gum or drink a glass of water and get rid of the ashtrays inside your home.
There are two pieces to the addiction to nicotine. It's both that physiological addiction, which is horrendous and uncomfortable in that withdrawal phase, but there's also that behavioral piece to it, and that's the piece that people forget about, and I think that's the piece that often brings them back years later.
That looks like so little.
When it comes to drinking alcohol, portion size comes into play. A standard serving is considered 5 ounces of wine or 1.5 ounces of liquor. Since most glasses and servings are much larger these days, use taller, thinner glasses. Your eyes will fool you into thinking you're actually getting more, but these glasses actually contain the same amount of liquid.
If you're at a restaurant and they serve drinks and it's possible to get it served in a tall, thin glass, be that crazy person that asks, "Can I have my drink in a tall, thin glass?"
Moderate drinking is defined as no more than one drink per day for women and no more than 2 drinks per day for men. While none of the ICANN challengers currently drink, Janice says if she can get her diabetes under control, she wouldn't mind a drink every now and then.
I have some friends that when we go places, they have a glass of wine when they have a nice meal, and I just want to try to do that, but I want to make sure it was healthy, that I was able to do it, and that, you know, I'm not going to do anything that's going to jeopardize my chronic disease.
It's not only the amount of alcohol to watch for, but the calorie content as well. Calories from mixers and calories from eating more after you've had, well, a few too many drinks, and your resolve is tested. More tips on our website at fox43.com. Click on the ICANN Challenge under the Features tab. So, let's take a look at this week's weigh-ins. Since last week, Jenny gained a bit more than 1.5 pounds, but she's still down 7.4 pounds since the start 5 weeks ago. Bob lost 3 pounds over the week. He's down now 1 pound overall. Vicki lost 0.2 pounds. She's down 5.4 pounds overall. And Felix is down 3.6 pounds. He actually lost 0.2 since last week, but his doctors say he has lost enough weight and now needs to concentrate on building muscle, working on his physical endurance, and watching his cholesterol and blood sugar numbers. Janice gained back the 1.4 pounds she's lost, but she's still working very, very hard. And I'm proud to say I am now down 10 pounds, halfway toward my goal. Now, keep in mind that since I don't have heart disease or diabetes, my goals are simply to lose fat. The others also have to watch blood sugar and heart issues. And keep in mind that weight doesn't tell the entire story. Those with diabetes are also reporting lower blood sugar. And everyone says the clothing these days fitting a bit better. So weights could go up as the challengers build more lean muscle mass. So we're halfway there. And next week, we work on overcoming obstacles and work on keeping going. Evan Forrester, Fox 43 News.